97.3 City FM. Relevant radio, always.
We are taking both a short-term and a medium-term view with respect to the value of the city, which, by the way, affects revenues to the cocoa farmer, affects the value of imports. So it's not just about debt, and therefore affects inflation. We're talking about inflation. So it is a factor, which means that it is something we must. And in the statement, I said that we are going to intensify reporting and monitoring of foreign exchange inflows, retention, and use under our laws and agreements to make sure that these are not being, you know, funny or abused. And I know the subject of the speculation, you know, which has been happening. So that's an exercise which the Ministry of Finance and Bank of Ghana are going to do. We are saying that we would enhance monitoring of foreign exchange transactions. We know what happens, you know, in forest bureaus, in, you know, all the black markets and whatever. It's important that we look at it. We're saying that part of the problem we have with the value of the currency is that when you get out of the cocoa season, you go straight into the lean season, the dry season, you know, November onwards, when, you know, one, you see food, you know, food supply, you know, dwindles because of our story. Part of it is in smallholder and other schemes. You also see, you know, demand going into Christmas for Forex and whatever. And you will notice that it is through that period going into May and June that you have the most difficult problem with the city. So Bank of Ghana will take new approaches, their swap arrangements and whatever, and enhance them. Those are the short term things. We are saying that even MDAs and MMDAs should import less, you know, where they can, because there's pressure. But then we said, structurally, what is the problem that we have had as a country? For centuries, it's been the cocoa farmer and the miner that has been bringing the foreign exchange that we are all talking about today. It hasn't changed structurally. The only thing that has changed recently is that crude oil has come to add. That's another primary. We also have seen that the prices of these three commodities on the international market can fall within the same period. That's what happened in the last 2 years. Gold prices fell, cocoa prices fell, which means that we have to diversify our source of supply, you know, of foreign currency. So we're saying that we must boost exports. We must move towards an export-led economy. One, we are proposing an Exim Bank, which will provide financing for exporters, as to begin SMEs, so that the pineapple exporters' rice can be boosted to an export, you know, maize, you know, and all those, the agrarian era in particular. When you move to petrochemical, you need to also boost exports. So we say that we are moving into it. We are saying that GIPC will have to start moving away from granting incentives, for example, for the establishment of malls. When you establish malls, it's mostly imported things that are sold, and towards exports.